Good morning. Today we will be discussing the Loran Sea, which is a method of position fixing on the high seas when vessels are navigating. And this topic indicates that we have to obtain positional information for plotting the position of the ship in various locations as we navigate on our course, whether it be dead reckoning position onward to a position obtained by Loran, which will be a fix. Considering Loran Sea, there have been various methods which were used to develop the position of the vessel, which including being Loran A and Loran B, and Loran C was finally progressed upon, which was used right from Second World War, considering the older versions, and used for position plotting and get accuracy of position, including aircraft and surface craft, that meaning ships, and getting a position while transiting during the World War II. This system was further developed, but as we all would know, considering our dependence upon GPS instruments or global positioning system instruments, which is satellite based, we now have a method of position fixing which was based on a totally terrestrial transmission method from various stations, and that was used to obtain the fix of the vessel, all things considered. Loran Sea was reasonably effective, and it has been used in the previous years to get good positional accuracy, but with a series of errors too, which must never be forgotten when plotting a position of the vessel during transit on a coastline. Loran can be categorized as long range navigation. Which means we can use it for up to 900 to 1200 nautical miles range. It is a hyperbolic system of position line fixing, a hyperbolic system of lines of position, this being generated by stations which transmit signals on a carrier wave of 100 kilohertz and are received by receiver instruments on ships when navigating within about 900 to 1200 miles off these stations. These were called Loran Sea chains, and were used very effectively to plot positions with their associated errors. And as I said, this is a hyperbolic system of position fixing. What does Loran Sea working principle depend on? As I said, it is a hyperbolic system of position fixing, and it is used to measure the time difference between a master station and either 2, 3, or 4 secondary or may also be called slave stations from each being placed hundreds of kilometers away from each other, by which I mean the master and the secondary, and thus taking advantage of two lines of position of between two sets of secondaries, we can plot fix. So the master station is generally always called M, and the secondary station is generally always called W, X, Y, or Z. You may either have the master will always be there. You may either have 2, 3, or 4 secondary stations, which I used for getting 2 lines of SOPs, 3 lines of SOPs, or 4 lines of LOPs, I would rather say. So, as I said, it is a hyperbolic system of navigation fixing. In this system, we, as I said, measure the time difference. The time difference being measured as TD, W, TD, X, TD, Y, and TD, Z, if there are 4 stations. By a method of transmission of signals at a carrier frequency of 100 kHz, we have a situation where atomic clocks or very high precision clocks are used to place signals into the terrestrial surface along the ground, and these signals are ensured to be at a very, very strict time varying schedule, by which I mean the master always transmits first, that is M transmits first, W, X, Y, and Z, depending on however many secondary stations are there, transmit only in that sequence. Thus, X will never come before M or W, Y will never come before M, W, or X, and Z will never come before M, W, X, or Y. This scheduling of signal transmission ensures proper receiver signal on the vessel, and we can obtain quite a good match of signals, which allows us to plot positions in proper sequence. How is this achieved? We are going to measure the time difference between the master and the secondary. That is the beginning of the pulse of the master and the beginning of the pulse of the secondary. We measure the time difference between the reception. This helps us in getting the position of the vessel along LOPs of a hyperbolic nature. To begin with, let us get into the nitty-gritty of these stations, the way they transmit and the way the signal is received on the ship. It is always ensured that there is a concept of GRI, also being mentioned as group repetition interval. This being a master signal of 9 pulses, with W having 8 pulses, X having 8 pulses, and the next master sequential signal having the beginning. So, what we have here is the signaling concept between master and the secondaries. This is called as time difference W, and this is called as time difference X, and this is called as the GRI. Now, time difference W shows a sequence of 9 pulses from the master, followed by a certain delay, and then a sequence of 8 pulses by the W secondary, followed by a certain delay, which is then followed by a sequence of 8 pulses by the X secondary, and then in case, as I said here, considering only 2 secondaries, those being W and X, from the beginning of the first master to the beginning of the next master, is 6 pulse, I mean, is called a group repetition interval. Now, these pulses each have a duration of 250 microseconds. The time difference between any 2 pulses in any sequence is 1000 microseconds, and the difference between the 8th and 9th pulse of the master is 2000 microseconds. This is called group repetition interval, and this function is used in transmission of signal from the transmitting station to the receiver onboard receiver unit onboard the vessel, which is used to processing this information. Please remember that all these time measurements are done with high precision atomic clocks, and though the vessel or the receiving unit on the vessel does not have a atomic clock, it is still used to obtain the LOPs with a particular number, and then we are able to plot the position of the vessel on the chart. The transmission from each of these stations for any error is continuously being monitored by the System Area Monitor or SAM, which in case of any discrepancy in timing, following signal or any other problem will cause a signal blink in the secondary signal, and this will assist the receiver in knowing when there is a problem with the receiver signal of either master or secondaries. Considering the hyperbolic system of navigation being used, I would like to further develop this concept and explain the issues regarding the basic concept of what is TD or time difference. This is the beginning of the concept, so we are just developing the concept. This line is called the baseline, and these on either side of M on the farther side and W on the other farther side is called a baseline extension. Now, in between M and W, a time gap of 2000 microseconds is maintained. As we all know, the velocity of radio waves is 300 into 10 to the power 6 meters per second, or to very well be stated to be 300 kilo, 300 meters per microsecond, which would cause us to have in in 2000 microseconds, we would have a distance of 2000 into 300 meters, which leads us to 600,000 meters, which is 600 kilometers, which works out to roughly 324 nautical miles. This being said, as we have observed that we place M and W due to technical reasons at a distance of 2000 microseconds, the distance between both is 324 nautical miles. Please do note that Lorentz sea uses radio waves. Radio waves having a speed of 300 into 10 to the power 6 meters per second. Now, what is the positional accuracy that we need to achieve? This is the center line in between either side of the stations and is said to be 0 microseconds. On either side is 100 microseconds, 200 microseconds, 300 microseconds, 400 microseconds. And this on the basal extension would be 2000 microseconds. Similarly, while this being the center line hyperbola having a 0 microsecond time difference, we would have a 100 microsecond time difference, 200 microsecond time difference, 300 microsecond, 400 microsecond, 1900 microsecond, and 2000 microsecond time difference. Now, what does this hyperbolic system of simultaneous transmission mean? We have a system of hyperbole which indicate the time difference between two different stations, one being the master and one being the secondary, and the center line is a 0 microsecond time difference. And we have, what does it mean? Now we come to the issue of what do we mean by 0 microsecond time difference. Let us consider a point P, R here on 100 on one side and Q on the other side. When the signal is transmitted from the master and the secondary simultaneously at the same time with radio wave frequency, it is received at P simultaneously because it is on the center line of the baseline. That being said, this point will receive the signal from both master and secondary W at the same time. Once it receives the signal from the master and the secondary at the same time, it means that the time difference between both master and secondary is 0. Therefore, the time difference would be 0. We are, as I said, developing the concept of Lorentz sea, which depends upon the principle of measuring time difference. After having considered this, Let us consider a point Q on the 100 microsecond hyperbola, which will have a closer distance to W rather than M. A closer distance to W rather than M. After having considered that, what we observe is, we can say that that point receives the master 100 microseconds later than the secondary W, because it is closer to the secondary W. Further noticing, along the 0 microsecond hyperbola, along with P, further points will all along the same hyperbola have the same time difference. And along the 100 microsecond hyperbola towards secondary W, a time difference of 100 microseconds all along. Expanding the idea, along the 200 microsecond hyperbola, we have positions which arrive with the signal from W 200 microseconds earlier than the signal from M. Similarly, 300, 400, up to 900 and 2000. Now let us basically just try and recapitulate this idea of how the signals are being received on the baseline extensions. Suppose we have a point here that we call as M. We would observe that, not M, let us, because master is M. We will call that C. We observe that while the C, and it is 100 microseconds distant from W in radio wave speed terms. It could take 100 microseconds from W, and from master it could take 2000 to reach W. Plus 100, so that would be 2100. So 2100 from M to C and 100 from W to C, so time difference would be 2000 microseconds. In a similar manner, transferring the whole concept onto the hyperbola on the side of master M, we have the 100 microsecond hyperbola R, as mentioned here, in which the signal from M arrives 100 microseconds earlier than the signal from secondary W. Similarly, all along the hyperbola of R, the signal from M would arrive 100 microseconds earlier than the signal from W. Like that, as I have expanded the concept on the side of W, we could have a center line on the other side towards M. We would have 100 microsecond earlier from M, 200 microsecond earlier from M, and similarly 2000 up to the baseline extension of the by baseline extension. All things considered, we are okay with this. And now we consider a vessel to either have a 400 microsecond position on either side. Thank you. we know the distance between M and W is 324 nautical miles. So when we have two positions, one S and one T, and they are having a time difference of towards W of 400 microseconds and towards M of S having a position like this of 400 microseconds towards M, we will notice that a time difference of 400 microseconds, because we are not sure which side we are, considering that we are receiving both the signal from the master and secondary. If we get a 400 microsecond difference, we could either be at S or T. But by our basic knowledge that between M and W, the distance is 324 nautical miles, so considering that these hyperbolae are quite far from each other, let us say there is a difference of 400 300 nautical miles between S and T. So we have a situation. Okay, students, with this we will develop the idea further. We have a distance of 300 nautical miles between S and T, and this distance will create an issue of knowing where we are, whether we are closer to S or closer to T. Considering we have had DR or dead reckoning position close to T 1 hour back, we would definitely be on T hyperbola, which indicates that we are quite knowledgeable about our position. So we can be sure of the discrepancy between S or T. Excuse me. But consider, let us expand the idea. Zero microseconds with a position called P, and we have the 100 microseconds with a position called Q towards the secondary W, and 100 microseconds towards the master with a position R. What happens if we notice that the time difference measured is say 20 microseconds, and due to it being only 20 microseconds, we could be either side quite close to the P hyperbola? That is, either towards M or towards W. In such a case, we are led to a situation where there is an ambiguity, because any position that we plot can mean we could be either here or here. This ambiguity will have thus to be cleared. This method would be called a simultaneous transmission of radio waves in the Lorentz frequency between master M and secondary W. Now we will have to find a method by which we can solve the ambiguity as mentioned there. In case we are close to the hyperbola P and get our position sorted out. Now, how do we solve the problem of the close by hyperbole on either side of the P hyperbola and get a proper position?
Microseconds, 2300 microseconds, 2400 microseconds, 3900 microseconds, and 4000 microseconds on the distal extension towards M. This is, students, we will be discussing further in the next class. Thank you.